constituents, we come up with a very important lecture of gross anatomy, anastomosis around elbow joint, or it is called cuboidal anastomosis. Now this is a important short note, and it can be helpful in various MCQs also, or in one mark question answers. It will be very helpful. It is very short. Based on the diagram, we are going to study. So anastomosis around elbow joint, or it is called cuboidal anastomosis. Here, first of all, we are going to draw on this side. This will be humerus. So we are going to draw the humerus, capitulum, and we are going to draw the trochlea and the medial epicondyle. So this is the humerus, and this is slightly angled border which I am showing. So medial epicondyle, this will be the lateral epicondyle, this will be the capitulum, this will be the trochlea. So therefore, now below that, the articulations of upper end of radius and ulna. So here we show the radius. Again, in a slight angled manner, we are going to show. So therefore, this is the radius, and here we are going to show, this will be the ulna. And so therefore, this is how we show. This is the articulation. More important is the anastomosis. Now, here, R for radius and U for ulna. So therefore, medial epicondyle, lateral epicondyle. Now the entire cuboidal anastomosis is divided into five different compartments. First compartment, medial. Now, in front of medial epicondyle, first compartment. Behind the medial epicondyle, second compartment. In front of lateral epicondyle, third compartment. Behind the lateral epicondyle, fourth compartment. And fifth compartment will be where the olecranon fossa is present. Now, why I am showing you in this dotted format? We draw always this dotted format, that means it is located posteriorly. So this dotted format is olecranon fossa. So anastomosis above the olecranon fossa is the fifth compartment. After dividing this cuboidal anastomosis in these five compartments, here first we draw the main artery. And which is the main artery? Brachial artery. So the brachial artery will be drawn in this way. Here we show that this is the brachial artery, and we show the division. So please draw this brachial artery in this way, where we divide it into these two divisions. Here we show these two divisions, and then we put the color pink color. Here it divides into radial and ulnar. Very simple, radial and ulnar. So therefore, we also mark this as brachial artery, and here we mark this as radial artery, we mark this as ulnar artery. After marking this, what we show is the first division of the brachial artery, very important division, that is profunda brachii artery. Of course, it is present in the posterior region, posterior to the humerus, in the radial groove. So therefore, in the form of dot, we show here, see here, we show this in the form of dot, profunda brachii artery. This dotted format will be profunda brachii artery, and therefore here we give the name as profunda brachii artery. Now we start with anastomosis on medial epicondyle. First, anastomosis present anterior to medial epicondyle. Two branches from above, one branch from below. So in front of medial epicondyle, anterior to medial epicondyle, the main branch coming from above will be a branch of brachial artery. And that branch of brachial artery will be known as in inferior collateral artery. So at this level, I will just highlight this brachial artery. At this level, we show the inferior, like this. Here we show this branching pattern. So therefore, this artery will be the main branch coming from the brachial artery, and therefore it will be known as inferior ulnar collateral artery, inferior ulnar collateral artery coming from above. From below, there will be a branch of ulnar artery. This is the ulnar artery. So once again, I'll highlight this ulnar artery. Branch of ulnar artery which will come from below, that will be anterior ulnar recurrent artery. So therefore, from here we show this as anterior ulnar recurrent branch. So therefore, these are the two main branches in anastomosis in front of the lateral epicondyle. Now here we give this name as inferior ulnar collateral artery, which is a branch of brachial artery, and from here, from below, this will be anterior ulnar recurrent artery, which is a branch of ulnar artery. Now there will be one more branch coming from above, which will also participate in this anastomosis in front of medial epicondyle, and that branch will be a branch of superior ulnar collateral artery. And superior ulnar collateral artery is a branch of brachial artery itself. So therefore, once again we show the superior ulnar collateral artery, the branch, here I am going to show, from here it will pierce intermuscular septum. So we are going to show in this way, then it will pass posteriorly. Now this artery passes posteriorly, so we have to show in the form of dot. Posteriorly, where it is piercing, we know that it is piercing the medial intermuscular septum, superior ulnar collateral artery. It will send a branch, here it sends a branch in front of medial epicondyle. So this is the branch of superior ulnar collateral. You draw a very small slender branch, a very small slender branch of superior ulnar collateral in front of medial epicondyle. So this completes the anastomosis in front of the medial epicondyle. Therefore, here we need to name this as superior ulnar collateral artery. See the difference between superior ulnar collateral and inferior ulnar collateral artery. Inferior ulnar collateral is the main artery in front of medial epicondyle, and superior ulnar collateral will pass, it will pierce the medial intermuscular septum, it will pass in the posterior side. Here, it will give a very small slender branch to participate in front of medial epicondyle. Now, anastomosis behind the medial epicondyle. Here also, two main arteries and one small slender branch. Anastomosis behind the medial epicondyle, the artery which is the major artery from above is obviously superior ulnar collateral artery. So therefore, that superior ulnar collateral artery, once again we show here in the form of dot, and we show that it is the main artery coming from behind, from above, branch of brachial artery, superior ulnar collateral artery behind the medial epicondyle. From below, there is another branch of ulnar artery. From below, branch of ulnar artery which will participate in anastomosis behind the medial epicondyle. And this branch is known as posterior ulnar recurrent artery. So therefore here, we are going to name this as posterior ulnar recurrent artery. So therefore, very simple now, in the anastomosis behind the medial epicondyle, one branch, slender branch, will be from inferior ulnar collateral artery. So therefore, that slender branch will come from inferior ulnar collateral artery. So here we are going to show that it has gone posteriorly, branch of inferior ulnar collateral artery. Now, anastomosis on medial epicondyle is complete. Very simple. Once again, anastomosis in front of medial epicondyle, the main branch coming from above is inferior ulnar collateral artery, which is a branch of brachial artery. Another branch coming from below is anterior ulnar recurrent artery, which is a branch of ulnar artery, and a small branch of superior ulnar collateral artery. Anastomosis behind the medial epicondyle, the main branch coming from above is superior ulnar collateral artery, which is a branch of brachial artery, and posterior ulnar recurrent artery, which is a branch of ulnar artery, and a small slender branch from inferior ulnar collateral artery. Here we complete the anastomosis in front of medial epicondyle and behind medial epicondyle. Based on this diagram only you can remember. And in this way so many MCQs can also be created, can be asked. Now we come to lateral epicondyle. This was very simple, medial epicondyle. Same way this is also very simple, based upon the branches, branching pattern only. Lateral epicondyle. In front of lateral epicondyle, there will be one branch coming from above. And that branch which is coming from above, it will be known as anterior descending artery, which is a branch of profunda brachii artery. So here, we draw this branch which is coming from above. And this is anterior descending artery. Or it is also known as, see the other name of this anterior descending artery will be, it is called the radial collateral artery. Now here we show that it will once again pierce, we are going to show like this, it is piercing the lateral intermuscular septum. After piercing lateral intermuscular septum, the branch of profunda brachii, this anterior descending will pass anterior in the anterior compartment. So this is the region where it will pierce this lateral intermuscular septum and enter the anterior compartment. Therefore, after drawing this clear diagram, we are going to name this as anterior descending artery, or otherwise you write this as radial collateral artery, anterior descending or radial collateral branch of profunda brachii from above. From below, there will be a branch of radial artery. This is the radial artery. So branch of radial artery will be, this will be known as the radial recurrent artery. This is the radial recurrent artery. So therefore, here we name this as radial recurrent artery, branch of radial artery. So therefore, this is the anastomosis in front of lateral epicondyle only. Two arteries, one from above, one from below. From above, anterior descending or radial collateral, which is a branch of profunda brachii artery. And from below, radial recurrent artery, which is a branch of radial artery. Now, anastomosis behind the lateral epicondyle. Behind the lateral epicondyle, once again two arteries, one from above, one from below. One from above will be, now this is also very interesting, one from above will be, now here I will show just deep. So this is known as posterior descending artery. And why I am showing you in dotted format is because it is lying posteriorly, deep. So therefore, this artery is called posterior descending branch, or in some textbooks it is also written as middle collateral artery. So here I show this anastomosis. Now this is behind the lateral epicondyle, and here we name this as posterior descending artery, or it is also known according to some textbooks as middle collateral artery. So this middle collateral artery or posterior descending is a branch of profunda brachii artery from above, and from below the artery which will anastomose with this posterior descending will be, this is also very interesting, now this ulnar artery will give a common introitus trunk which will divide into posterior and anterior introitus arteries. So here I have drawn this common introitus. Now this is the common interosseous artery, which is a branch of ulnar artery, which will divide into, this will be the anterior interosseous artery, and this will be the posterior interosseous artery. So posterior interosseous artery will give one branch which will be known as interosseous recurrent branch. So here we have to show this will be the interosseous recurrent branch. Here I am showing this is interosseous recurrent branch, and this is the anastomosis. So this is the interosseous recurrent branch, and please name
this as interosseous.
We name this as interosseous recurrent branch, which is a branch of posterior interosseous artery, which is a branch of ulnar artery, which will anastomose behind the lateral epicondyle with posterior descending or middle collateral. Here we finish the lateral epicondyle. Anastomosis in front and behind. Once again, anastomosis in front of lateral epicondyle. Very simple. One branch coming from above, anterior descending, or it is called radial collateral artery, which is a branch of profunda brachii artery. One branch coming from below, which is also known as the radial recurrent artery, which is a branch of radial artery. Then anastomosis behind the lateral epicondyle. Branch coming from above, posterior descending, or it is called middle collateral artery, which is a branch of profunda brachii artery. And the branch which is coming from below, that branch which is coming from below is interosseous recurrent artery, which is a branch of posterior interosseous artery, and which is a branch of ulnar artery. So therefore, here we finish anastomosis around lateral epicondyle. Now the last one, the last is anastomosis just above olecranon fossa, posteriorly. Remember, this olecranon fossa is posteriorly. So two branches, two transverse branches which will anastomose just above olecranon fossa will be, one transverse branch will be from the middle collateral artery. Which is the middle collateral artery? This posterior descending artery, this one is the middle collateral artery. So here this is the middle collateral branch. So therefore, now this transverse branch of middle collateral artery along with the transverse branch of inferior ulnar collateral artery. So here this is the transverse branch of posterior division of inferior ulnar collateral artery, and here we show this anastomosis. In this way we show the anastomosis. So here we have to name this as here transverse branch. This is the transverse branch of the posterior descending or middle collateral artery. Transverse branch of posterior descending or middle collateral artery. And this one, this is the transverse branch of that of the posterior division of inferior ulnar collateral artery. Transverse branch of middle collateral or transverse branch of posterior descending artery along with the transverse branch of the middle collateral, along with the transverse branch of the posterior division of inferior collateral artery, they will have anastomosis just above the olecranon process, the olecranon fossa, that is on the posterior side of the lower end of the humerus. So here we have completed the anastomosis around elbow joint. Once again, medial epicondyle, in front of medial epicondyle, then behind the medial epicondyle, in front of lateral epicondyle, behind the lateral epicondyle, and above the olecranon process. In this way, by this diagrammatic view, remembering two arteries, one from above, one from below, except on the lateral epicondyle where there will be one more branch from above, so there will be total 3 arteries. So in this way you can remember the entire anastomosis of the elbow joint, and from this entire short knot, this can be asked as a short knot also. From this short knot, there are various MCQs which can be asked from this entire topic. Thank you very much.